Hey, welcome back to Urban Smith. And on today's episode, we are going to be talking about how you can raise enough capital to invest in your first rental property. You may be asking yourself, how can I get more money? You want to quit your job? We are going to answer all those questions in this episode. There's going to be a few surprises, so make sure you stay tuned to the very end. So let's get started. Maybe asking yourself, you want to quit your job and you want to start your own business. That's why you're watching this episode, right? You want to invest in rental property, maybe Airbnb, or if you have a secondary home and don't know where to start and you want to list that house to get some more side income, or you heard of the word passive income. Passive income is income acquired by putting in little to no work and often combined in a side job. So you may be asking yourself, I want passive income. How can I get started? Rentals, vacation spots. So in this episode, we're going to be teaching you on how to get capital for an investment property. Before we move any further, if you could do me a huge favor and go hit that subscribe button, it would definitely help me as a YouTube channel. And make sure if you enjoy this video, hit that bell notification. That way you get notifications every time I drop a video. So stay tuned to the very end of this episode, and I'm going to teach you a method on how to start saving tons of money, and you can do it right now if you own your own home. So you've realized investment properties is passive income. Furnish it, put little to no work, and you put it on Airbnb, Furnish Finder, and it starts renting. Sounds pretty easy. And if you did this multiple times, say 10, 15 times, you can create a huge amount of income coming in. So you may be asking yourself, I don't have enough capital to invest in a rental property or an investment property. How can I make more money and get into an investment property? That way, ultimately, I can leave my W-2 job. So the first thing is you have to stay at your W-2 job. So find out how much your spending habits are. You know how much you make in your W-2 job. So let's say you make $3,000 every single month and you go out and spend it on fast food. You go spend it on groceries, your mortgage, your rent, insurance, your car insurance, gas. You know how much you spend every single month. If you do a breakdown of everything that you spend and your monthly income and subtract everything, you'll have X amount of how much you can save. And that's the first thing, is figure out your spending habits and what can you save from your W-2 job.
This is the worst.
You may be asking yourself, okay, so I figured out how much I can save, but that's not going to be enough. It's going to take me years to save $30,000 to $40,000 because I only have $50 left over.
No, God! No, God, please, no, no!
So figure out your bills. So for instance, your cable bill, are you paying cable and Wi-Fi? Can you lower that service to a lesser premium service? So if you pay for the top tier of your internet, why not lower that down, live beneath your means, and do that for a few months, and you can still save a huge amount of money. Same thing with your cable. Nowadays, a whole lot of people don't even have cable anymore. You have Netflix, you have Hulu Plus, you have all the streaming services that are a lot cheaper than going out and paying for Comcast services that are $100 to $150 for cable. So that's $150 that you could be saving on top of your $50 that you are not spending out of your check. With just those two things, you're already saving $300 a month. So figure out what you can lower your bills to, figure out how much you can save, and ultimately you have a little nice egg that you can save every single month. And if you do that for a year and a half, 2 years, you can have enough capital to put into an investment property. Think of the long haul. You can't think of the short term. Everybody thinks short term within month to month. If you're living paycheck to paycheck, you are thinking paycheck to paycheck.
Did it by saving and investing their income.
If you want to leave your W-2 job, then you have to think of 5-10 years from now. And you can change your whole entire world in 5 years. Your W-2 job is guaranteed money, so don't quit. If you want to get into passive income, your first step is having guaranteed money. Take your money that you make from your W-2 and you start saving some of it. That way you can put into a investment property. You may be asking yourself, I have bills to pay and I have credit cards. So that's the first thing you need to tackle. If you haven't heard of Dave Ramsey, there's a snowball effect that he implies for people that are in debt that I did myself. We had about $15,000 worth of debt and we got out of that debt within 2 years. But what we did is we started saving a ton of money and put that whole $2,000-$3,000 that we can save in a few months and start tackling these credit cards. You will not get approved for an investment property loan, a FHA loan, an investment property loan, or a conventional loan because your debt to income ratio is too high. The next thing you could do once you start saving your W-2 money is go find a side hustle. Go on DoorDash. Go find a secondary job. Rich people don't sleep 8 hours of the day.
This is just stupid. It's stupid on steroids.
Go sleep 5 hours, 6 hours, and go get a side job. Use that side job money to start paying off all your debt and start saving some of that money. The number one reason why people fail at this is they don't save their money and they go spend it on stupid stuff. Go to your Chase app or go to your Capital One card, go to your bank statement, and in one single month, add up every single time you went to spend it on fast food. That's it. The number will surprise you. So stop spending money on fast food. Stop spending money on cable. Stop spending money on going out to the bar.
I don't know what you mean.
Start saving this money. And if you did this for 6 months to a year to 2 years, you'll have a large nest egg that way you could put in an investment property. Let's say you have zero money and you want to start saving money, but you own your own home. Start a house hack. Let's say you have a garage and you put, you know, a few thousand dollars into the garage and converted that garage into a spare bedroom. House hack it. Guys, there's money to be made and you have to think outside the box. So if you learned anything, make sure you go comment down below, and after that, go hit that subscribe button. So this is Urban Smith. We're checking out. See y'all next time.